Hi, I'm Janice, the founder of Mommy Mundo, and we've come together with the Dove Self-Esteem Project to spark conversations with moms in our community and talk about the struggles of self-esteem that young girls go through today. Did you know that as part of the Dove Self-Esteem Project, they created the Unique in Me module to give us tools to help instill self-confidence in our young daughters moving forward? We have with us here three moms and their daughters to begin the conversation. We asked each daughter to answer some questions on what they think about themselves both physically and as a person and have their moms react to it and comment on afterward.
Hi, my name is Mika. I'm 11 years old and I love to eat.
Hi, my name is Nicci. I'm 10 years old. I'm athletic.
Hi, my name is River. I am 7 years old and I like to make friends.
Hi, my name is Sky. I'm 10 years old and I love to sing.
Actually, I think my face. I like how the face has the ability to make people feel warmer, like when you see them and you flash a smile and it brings joy to them.
I like how I look because when I look in the mirror, I usually see my dad. I'm friendly. I can also be strong and competitive. Like if everybody is sad, I just have to be strong for them and not cry.
I like that I make friends. I like my eyes because they're big and black and bright.
My mommy and my daddy tell me that I have pretty eyes.
My talents and my personality. Because my talents, first of all, help me express myself. And my personality is what makes me. And without my personality, I am not Sky.
No, I wouldn't want to change anything about my body because I learned how to be comfortable in my own skin. My mom and dad always tell me to be grateful for what I have because not everybody has what you have.
I'm grateful for how I look, but it just kind of gets frustrated when my hair gets really curly, like if I didn't dye it.
It makes me look like, oh, that's you.
When I see people with curly hair, I'm like, it looks nice, but when I have curly hair, it doesn't look nice.
Hi, I'm Thammie, and I'm the mom of Mika.
Hi, I'm Mafae, and I'm the mom of Nicci.
Hi, I'm Sheila, and I'm the mom of Sky and River.
Okay, Thammie, Mafae, and Sheila, hello.
Hello.
So how did you find our exercise? It's really interesting to find what's in the brain of our children, the always. So my first question is, would your child say something that you were surprised to hear?
Well, I think it was the part when Mika was talking about her hair. So we had a particular family member, a relative, who would always point out her hair growing up. And every time we'd come from their house, we'd have to debrief her. Okay. So we'd always talk about her value, that it's not her identity, her how loved she is. It's not based on how she looks or how her hair is.
Sometimes girls, we say that when we have to measure ourselves against other girls.
Like, yeah.
How did that make you feel when she mentioned it?
You know, help her balance.
Yeah.
Balance that they're in a game or in any kind of competition, there's always going to be a winner and a loser. Yeah. And that's just the reality of it all.
That's right.
And when you do lose, how do you get better?
So. Yes. How important is it that girls are confident in their own skin?
We can't really control what other people tell them about who they are or what they absorb from the internet, social media, or from their friends or peers or teachers. Mm. But we can always plant that seed and, you know, that seed of confidence, self-esteem, and, you know, that faith in knowing that you were created to be special, that you were created for a purpose and live for that purpose. I think confidence stems from that, knowing that you have a role to play in this world. And I guess that's something that I really want to emphasize in all my girls, actually.
With Nicci, she had questions on her appearance because when she was born, she was the cord was wrapped around her neck, her arm, and her leg. And so her ear, one of her ears, there's a on the tip, it folds. And so there was a time that she was very
you know, asking why is it like that. So I just keep reminding her that she's special, you know, she's not supposed to be like everybody, you know. It's better that you're different and that you stand out and that, you know, when you gain respect for yourself, others will respect you back.
I would want them to be comfortable and confident so they can just give of themselves. If they know that they're approved of, they know that they have a purpose, they know that they are loved, then they can give love. Yes. Then they can live out their purpose. Then they can fully live their lives, not for themselves and to get that pat on the back all the time, mm-hmm. but to just really share and love people.
Okay, lastly, we know about the Uniquely Me module. Mm-hmm. How do you think this can help start the conversation going in the home between mm-hmm. moms and daughters?
After reading the module, it really does help. Mm-hmm. And sometimes parents do need that reminder because mm-hmm. Like that, this generation is all about technology on social media. So how do you address that?
It's always hard to start that conversation and to find like where to begin or what topics to bring up, and anything that helps with that aspect is a good thing for me. Like, it's a step closer to bridging that gap or addressing issues that are unmentioned or, you know, things that we think are untouchable. A guide like that helps us find the right questions to ask and know what to expect when they answer.
So it's an objective tool. I think one of the things, like the reality is, as parents, I think we sometimes end up as white noise. If we say the same thing over and over again, but they hear it from somebody else and they realize, oh, it's not just my mom who believes that. So I think it's a good tool, and I don't think that there's one big talk. Confidence and self-esteem and I think it's an ongoing conversation that we need to have. It's a long process.
I mean,
So I think it's an ongoing process. So like you said, anything that can help keep that conversation going is really good.
So that's all. Well, thank you for sharing your day with us and for sharing your drills with us. I mean, we can already see how confident they are in their own skin, and that makes us so proud, even me. It's amazing, and we just hope that all girls will grow up that way.